I invite you to tune in to My Air, A.I.R. with Tracy Newbill-Etheridge, y'all. That's me. I'm the one and the only Tracy Etheridge. Yes, baby, that's me.
Thank you, thank you, thank you for tuning in to My Air, A.I.R. with Tracy Newbill-Etheridge, y'all. That's me. I'm the one and the only Tracy Etheridge. Yes, baby. That's me. Oh, my God, y'all will not believe who I have on the platform today. Whew, wait a minute. Let me get myself together. Cause I want y'all to hear who I got. My sister. Y'all, she follows me. I follow her. She know about me. I know about her. But honey, I went all the way to Charlotte, North Carolina, y'all. Hey, baby. I went to Charlotte, North Carolina, and I got the one. The only. Sharon Champagne Terry, what up, girl? I am so happy to finally.
Yes.
I got to say that. Finally. Yes. Get you on my platform, girl. You
are such a busy woman. To get in where I fit in.
Girl, and you have email. I've been emailing you back. You email Diamond email you back. We did it.
We're here, yes.
But not only, I'm not the only one busy now. Because I see you. You're here, you're there, and you're everywhere. So you wear many hats, baby. You wear many hats. So with that being said, sis, I just wanted you to come on and to share with the people, not just little small little town. We talk about a national era. We talking about YouTubers. We talking about Tubi girl. We my elf being on Tubi girl. We finna be on Tubi.
Yes. Yes, yes.
This is what we're talking about. We want you to share who you are, what you do, what you bring, because you bring a lot. I see the awards you win. I see the platforms that you stand on. And you stand on it boldly. And that's what I love about you. If nobody ever told you, sister girl, I'm finna tell you now. Girl, you is doing your thing. You doing it. And you doing it unapologetically. I see you. I see you with your necklaces on. I see you with the big queen. I said, look at my girl. Look at my girl. I want you to tell them. I want them to hear from you how you are doing it. Because you're doing it gratefully. And to God be the glory.
Yes.
Do not underestimate the power of God.
Yes, yes. First and foremost.
So I want to turn the table, y'all, because they always hear. They hear my voice. They hear my voice every day. But I want to turn the tables on to you and just let you share with us who you are, what you do, and what you bring to this industry.
Okay. So thank you again for having me.
You're welcome.
It's such a pleasure to be here. You know, I love you. I love you and everything that you're doing.
Thank you.
And this is an amazing platform that you're bringing for people to get the notoriety that they need.
Right.
So I thank you for having me.
Thank you.
I had to say that because I truly do love her and everything she's doing.
Oh, wow.
But, of course, back to me and what I'm doing. I will humbly say, by the grace of God, I am a author,
yes.
A screenwriter,
yeah.
A model, a professional model,
yes.
An actress, and a motivational speaker.
Wow.
So I am doing many things, yes. many, many things in this time.
Yeah.
And I've been so blessed to be not busy, just busy, but productive.
Productive.
And I'm grateful for that. Yes. I am very grateful for that.
Awesome. Girl, I'm telling you, just like I say, I follow you on social media. And we may not talk, but I always know that the love is there. The love is there, always.
Yes.
And with the likes and the loves that we've put out to each other, it does not fall on deaf ears. You know, like my thing, it don't fall on deaf ears, baby.
Yes.
And I get that all the time. They say, girl, every time I do it, everybody start doing it. But it does not. Because I see you. I see what you do. And you are an inspiration to me. And you don't even know that. And I get me being inspiration to a lot of people, a lot of followers that follow me. But y'all don't know. Y'all are inspiration to me, to make me keep going and put out the content that I put out, because I don't look at the likes, I don't look at the followers, I never look at that.
Yes.
I don't need but one person that I can help, that I can empower, that I can inspire.
Mm-hmm.
That's all I need.
Yes.
And I know I have it in you, girl, because I see you.
Yes.
I see you.
Listen, you have inspired me when I saw you.
Yes.
Even though I've been, filming and stuff.
Yes.
Still, it's just to see you go from, modeling to now TV. Wow, that is amazing.
Jesus, God is good.
And you inspired me to keep going because, of course, no matter how long you've been in the industry, there's those roadblocks,
That's right.
No matter what industry.
That's right.
You inspire me as well, I promise. And I'm always looking at your content, of course, and likes, loves, comments, all of that.
Yes.
Because I enjoy seeing others doing what they enjoy.
Joy, yes.
That's a beautiful thing.
Yes. So let me ask you, are you from Charlotte? Or because your accent is not Charlatan.
No.
Okay, I know you, I think you up north somewhere.
Yes. I'm actually from Rochester, New York, upstate New York. So everybody says that.
Yeah.
You're not originally. No, I'm not. But I've been here about 5 years.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm stuck here now. I love it here. So it's the weather.
Yes, it is. It is the weather. That is so true. I used to work in Charlotte before I went to BMW. I was at the PD's office in Charlotte. Downtown Charlotte. So I know Charlotte is the queen city. Trust me,
yes,
it's the queen.
Yes, it is.
Yes, and I have a lot of colleagues in Charlotte, so I know Charlotte is booming, and they're growing, and they're growing, and I also can say a lot of Northerners are flocking to Charlotte because of the weather. Because of the growth that Charlotte is doing.
Yeah.
Yes.
Literally a lot of my family was down here years ago.
Oh, okay.
10, 15 years ago.
Yes.
So I think more or less we've been flocking down here.
Yes.
Slowly. So it looks like it's more of us now.
Yes.
Because we're just coming at a higher rate.
Right,
now,
yeah.
We actually been down here. I have a lot of family that been down here for a while.
Wow.
So many years. So, and yes, it's growing.
Yes.
I'm meeting people from everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
I met someone from Detroit.
Yes.
I met someone, it's been from
everywhere.
California.
Wow.
So it's just a growing city, which is a great thing.
Yeah, it really is.
Diversity.
Exactly.
Yes.
That is so true. So with this being said, you in Charlotte now, how did you get started? Did you just wake up one day and say, you know what? I'm finna write. I'm just finna get this pen. Let me get my I'm finna get child up. I'm finna. And I ain't looking back. So tell us, how did you get started? I mean, what just blossomed into where you at today?
Wow, I tell you, what started me was, actually, I started journaling because I was going through a lot in my life at that time. I had a big transition in my life. And I always say it's pain to purpose. I lost everything that could possibly matter to me at that moment. And so I started journaling, you know, everything. Wow. Everything, how I feel, what was going on, and everything. And I was like, this sounds like a book, right? Mm-hmm. And literally, probably 2 months after that, I literally started writing down book ideas and started a month after that writing books.
Wow.
So it was a pain to purpose.
Yes.
Thing. Yeah.
Oh, wow. That is awesome, girl.
Yes.
And you know what? I'm hearing a lot of that about journaling. Yes. A lot of people, I'm a journalist too. I love the jot down and a lot of my content is from my journals.
Journal.
Yes. Go ahead.
No, you're fine. I think it's therapy for a lot of people.
It is.
I mean, I can speak personally for myself.
Right.
It has been therapy for me. Just to write down and then go back and read journal and see where I was. You know, 3 months ago, and now I'm in a different space to see my own growth. So
that's right.
Journaling is literally like a another step to therapy.
Yes, it really is. It really is. And I second emotion that, because I do a lot of journal. I just had lost my father, so I did a lot of journaling of how I was feeling. And all of that. But it also gave me content. It gave me a will to do.
Yes.
To continue to do. Because I could have went, I'm my only girl. I'm the daddy's girl. I'm
that feeling. I'm the daddy's girl. And so when I literally saw, you know, and my heart goes out.
Thank you, girl. You know, thank you.
I'm a daddy's girl too, and I literally felt every inch of that post. And you know, I was like, my condolences to you and your family. I can't imagine. My dad is like my best friend.
Yeah.
So I can imagine, you know, how that would feel. But, you know, I even though everyone has to go, I don't want to feel that.
No.
I know
nobody wants.
It has to be difficult.
Yeah.
But at the same time, breathtaking, because you did have him in your life.
Yes.
And be able to,
exactly.
You know, embrace that relationship and those memories. So,
exactly.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, I did. And I'm still, you know, I still put myself together. But the memories are just amazing. But get back to girl. Let me get on back to you.
You know, we can go everywhere. So yeah.
I'm telling you, I'm telling you, we follows each other. She know a lot about me. I know a lot about her. Girl, I'm telling you, when I was seeing you, you had won an award.
Yeah.
And I was so happy. Girl, I felt like I was there with you. I was like, oh my God, yes! Yes! My girl did it!
Yes. And that is true. When you support each other, that's how you feel. And I feel the same way. Like, I inboxed you and said, hey, when I first saw that you had the show, I was so proud.
Yes, it did. Yes,
and,
it did.
You know, that's just what it's about.
Yeah, it is.
You know, people think it's the end of getting to the goal, but it's not. It's the journey, the support, and all that along the way. And, you know, and then the goal is met in your life.
Yes, that's so true. That
is. Doesn't feel as good. Like, you know, you're like, okay, I'm here now, let's
dance. Yes, exactly. But when you have somebody that's, you know, is dancing with you, it feels amazing.
Yes, it does.
I want to elaborate on, you know, some of your books, because and where can we purchase them, because I know they're out there. Amazon, Prime, Girl, tell us about it.
So Amazon, Barnes and Noble, Book a Million, you can contact me. Yes. You can go on my website and purchase.
Okay.
AuthoressChampagne.com.
Okay.
I have a few collaborations with this, which is anthologies.
Yes.
So that will be The Crossover, which has been my latest book as of last year. We released that with Natasha Gary. Dark Memories is also with four other authors.
Wow.
I have a series which is called The Goddess of Lust, Love, and Infatuation.
Ooh.
And then that's part one. And then part two is Blissful Lust. So, yes,
ooh.
I do.
What about the right
of do? Yes, and you know, I'm so grateful for the humble beginnings, you know.
Yes.
I still write as an author. I'm actually writing something now some other authors as well.
Yes.
But I kind of focus more on my screenwriting and directing.
Right.
Wow. Yeah, because I turned my books into, my first two books, I turned them into a TV series. So I've been working on that. Yeah, it's been amazing.
Oh,
that experience was amazing.
Yes.
Oh my God. The work is, it's a lot of work.
Yeah.
But the experience alone, like, gives me that drive.
Yes.
Like, literally. Not only am I writing it, I'm producing
it.
And funding. Yes. My own project.
That's
so
awesome.
It's been a blessing by the grace of
God yeah,
to do this. So
that is, oh girl, I'm bubbling inside.
Yes.
just for you for all that you're doing. I got to write the books down, y'all, because we got to do this lusting thing. I want to read about this lusting thing going on. This love and lust.
You know what? And that's what I get all the time.
Really?
But literally, there's lust, there's infatuation.
Yes.
There's spirituality.
Yep.
And there's drama. So you know, it's a diverse,
yes,
a diversity of everything
in one book.
So that people can actually relate to them.
Yes. Oh,
yeah.
Wow. And we can get that on Amazon.
Yes.
The Books A Million, all that. Okay, cool.
Barnes and Noble.
We'll have all that, yeah, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to have all that on our website for you. So when y'all go... Hey, we want y'all to support my sister. She doing her thing. I'm telling you, she doing her thing, y'all. So, so you're doing the... What? Because you're going to do all your series. Where is it? Where can we view that on?
So, it was on Roku.
Okay.
On MJO Network. But now we just finished filming... the second part of this first season.
Yeah,
So it's going to be on Roku. It's going to be on Apple.
Oh, good. Okay.
Android TV.
So, yes.
Yeah, so we're getting ready to launch. Yeah, so I'm excited.
Well, you make sure that you keep us connected. So when you do your launch, we will be in the place with you.
Yes. I'm excited. I would love that.
Yes.
Oh my gosh.
We will be there. To God be the glory. Like my grandmama used to say, we will be there we will be there high road if the creek don't rise.
Okay. Now see these sayings down here.
Yeah.
I've never heard of that.
But
it's such great saying.
Yeah.
You know, you just grasp onto it.
Right. And I know what my grandma used to say, I'll be there if the creek don't rise. I was like, well, you're right, because if the creek rise, you won't be there. Oh, my God. And so, but yeah, you definitely keep us informed on your launch or just anything that you have going on. Let us know so we can put it out there.
Yes.
Just like I was just telling you, we're doing our 10 episodes, first season on Tubi. Yes. We'll be on Tubi. So, girl, to God be the glory. Yes. Just the support that we have been receiving, the help that we have been receiving, the outpouring of, girl, you need to be on Tubi. We want to see you where we can be in our home and we can say, we want to see My Air. Or we want to see this film director. Or we want to see this author. We want to, and this is the platform that God had that allowed me to birth into reality. And yes, I'm just so grateful. I'm so grateful.
That is huge, though.
Yes.
I know you're a very humble person, and I love that about you, but you have to pat yourself on the back. You went from a model to the air to now to a network. Like, that is huge.
Yeah.
And, you know, I know we want to be humble beginnings or whatever, but you have to celebrate. Because if you don't celebrate, you're going to keep just going and going and never learn how to celebrate yourself.
Right, exactly. You're right. You are so right, girl. I'm so humble and I'm so excited about, you know, especially the Tubi, you know, network and you know, now that you have brought it to my attention. I have went from modeling, and I love modeling. I still model. And then I went to radio because I was in Charlotte on the radio.
Yes, I remember that.
And then I went from radio, and I said, you know, let me dab into this TV thing. But God opened the doors when he'll knock, but He expect us to open the door and go in. He said, I knock. I always will knock, but it's up to you to, open that door and go into it.
Yeah, yes, it is. I agree with that. Yes. I agree. And good thing you went through that door. Look at how many people you are assisting with this beautiful platform.
Yes, yes.
Like, you just don't know it. And I've done many interviews, but...
Yes.
This, every time I get on someone's platform, it's like the first time for me again.
Yes.
Because I'm so grateful.
Grateful.
To have a platform.
Right, exactly.
Yeah.
And then have a positive platform. That's the thing. Because a lot of people have platforms.
Oh, Jesus. My God.
Let's talk about it. Look, let's talk about it.
We're not going to do that. Be done with this interview.
Okay, girl, I'm telling you, but you know, I'm just thankful to have a positive platform
to where
I can bring individuals. You know, yes, My Air stands for alopecia is real, because I definitely want to show, you know, my crown and show that you can do whatever you want to do with or without hair.
Yes.
But I also wanted to bring individuals that's doing extraordinary things in the community, like such as yourself. And so I'm just so grateful to not only have you as a Facebook friend, sister, queen, but I'm so grateful just to have you, you know, as my inspirational piece. Because I'm telling you, I follow you, and I see, you know, I see your ups, I see your downs, I see when you having a down day, and I pray for you more. When I see, I pray for you more.
Yes.
You know, you may not say it, you may not, you know, and that's me. We may not say it in the
in the moment.
In the moment. But the real no.
That's right.
The real no.
Yes. Yes.
So I just want to
thank you for that, because I'll tell you, people will see you having those days instead of you know, uplifting you in mm-hmm. prayer or, you know,
right.
sending out kind words or something, you know, they do the opposite.
Opposite.
Of that. So I am very grateful yeah. to have you send my name up in prayers.
Oh,
and
yeah.
I do the same for you. I do.
Yes.
So, you know, I want to see you succeed.
Yes.
You know, I want to be in that audience,
yes.
you know, one day when you're as big as Oprah, you know.
Ooh.
So, yes. And it's the sky's the limit.
Sky's the limit.
Sky's the limit.
That is so, oh my God, thank you, girl. What, honey, now, with that being said, honey, tell the people how they can contact you, how they can get in contact, how they, if they just want to just see you on Facebook, how, tell them, girl.
So you can definitely, I'm on, oh, geez, everything.
Yeah, you are.
Facebook, Instagram.
Yes.
Alignability.
Yes.
Twitter. Sheesh. I don't know what other.
Are you on TikTok?
Yes, I'm on TikTok as well. I forgot about it. So many.
It is so many. But is all of those under your name?
Yes.
Gotcha.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. You know what? No. Because, sheesh, Instagram is under author.
Okay, that's right.
Champagne okay. and Twitter is under authoress Champagne.
Okay.
All the other are under Sharon Champagne Terry.
Okay.
Yes. And you can also go to my website, www.authoresschampagne.com.
Yes.
You can connect with me there. You can contact me personally in my inbox. Send me a DM.
Exactly.
I mean, I may not get to you right away, but I will respond. I it is a must
yes.
for me to connect with my
supporters. That's how I am. That's right.
On a regular basis, yes. because like you and I want to be able to say I know them. I know mm-hmm. I can't know everybody.
Right.
I have a lot of supporters.
Yes.
But for those who are continuous supporters,
yes.
I do want to be able to know
acknowledge.
You.
Acknowledge. At least
how
acknowledge.
Are you when exactly. is in your life.
Exactly.
You know?
Yes.
So, yes.
Oh my God! Again, girl, I want to thank you for
thank
just
you.
Coming on and sharing who you are. You are the one and the only, honey. Ain't nobody like you, honey. Ain't nobody like you. When he made you, he made just you.
Thank you.
And you doing it very well. You doing it very well.
Thank you so much. I appreciate you. I always tell people, now I can do that thing like you can Google me.
Yeah. Like, Google me, baby.
I want it so bad to be able to say that.
Yeah, right.
Say that.
Yep.
You do,
yeah. I love
so,
it.
Thank you so much for yeah. Just having me and, you know, in your beautiful presence.
Thank
because you.
You
are a beautiful soul.
Thank you so much. I appreciate
and,
it.
And I am so grateful. Anytime you want me on here,
girl,
whatever.
Yep.
I'm here. I'm here to chop it up.
Chop
it,
yeah.
Whatever. Cry, whatever we need to do.
We do.
To be able to have a successful, you know,
yes.
session.
You're right. That's right. That
yeah.
is so true. And I appreciate that. And I'm kind of trying to mean.
Yes, ma'am.
Sharon.
Yes, ma'am.
Girl. I love it. I love it. So with that being said, thank you again, you guys,
yes.
for joining and tuning in to My Air, y'all. Y'all, we had the lovely, my beautiful, my queen, my sister, honey, my commandant.
Yes, yes.
Miss Sharon. Champagne Terry, y'all, baby. Y'all, this ain't gonna be the only time y'all gonna see her. She is gonna come back. She might be a co-host somewhere. She might be sitting next to me. But honey, with that being said, y'all, thank y'all, thank y'all, thank y'all for tuning in to My Air A.I.R. with Tracy Newbill-Etheridge, y'all. Y'all tired. Y'all know that's me. The one and the only. Woo! Tracy Etheridge. Yes, baby. Y'all be blessed. And again, I say thank you. Tune in every week in Saturdays and Sundays on Watch Fox 57 in Columbia, South Carolina, as well as Fox 31 in Albany, Georgia. You can also go to our website, www.weareMyAir.com. You can also Tune into our YouTube channel. All of our episodes will be on our YouTube channel at www.youtube.com/@myair2023. Y'all go ahead and do that now. Subscribe, I said. Support. Y'all be blessed. Love you guys. And again, I say thank you for tuning in to My Air. Y'all.
All right, go. So, girl, okay, so now that we back, because you know this Zoom mess be just knocking us off.
Yes.
Especially when it get good. But, girl, how was your interview? We want to just have a feedback on, because it may can improve us. How can we get, be improved or... And all of that. How was your experience on being?
It was great. I think your interaction and your questioning, and also giving us the room to be able to respond, in a timely manner. I think you did a wonderful job. Okay. I love the way you do, and your energy is amazing. So it feeds off.
Everybody's telling me
I'm just laughing and I'm smiling. And I'm like, yeah.
Everybody, all the film directors, all the actors, they all saying the same thing.
Yeah.
You know what? I give honor to God, who's the head of my life, and
that's right.
I do it. The personality that God has given me allows me to do this.
Yes.
Who I am, I love my word. Do it unapologetic.
Absolutely.
Yes.
I am so there with you. Yeah. And that's what I love. A lot of people don't know how to be themselves, like in front of the camera or certain type of work. They have certain different type of personalities in whatever the environment is, but they don't understand if you just be you, it works. Yes, exactly.
And that's what a lot of, it's a lot of film, a lot of big actors and a lot of rappers and stuff, that's what they deal with. They're trying to not be them. They're trying to be this person on the stage or out here in public. And then behind those, they're trying to separate the two. But,
it's hard.
You don't have to worry about that,
Right.
And
yes.
And not allow the money to change who you are.
Exactly.
Absolutely.
And when you let money change, that's when you deal with culture and a personality change.
Yes.
Consistently fighting a battle.
Yep. Yes, you are. I agree with that. You are. And that's the thing. In any industry, you have to learn to be yourself. It's a consistent battle, because you can easily adopt someone else's professional ethics.
Right.
It's very easy to do that when you work with multiple people on a regular basis. It's so easy to pick up things that aren't you. So just staying true to yourself is like one of the things that makes you, whatever industry you're in.
Exactly. That's so true. Drop gem.
Drop gems.
Now,
that's true.
Now, what I had noticed in the interview, and I want to get a little bit more and our people to get to know a little bit more. So, as you are author, right?
Yes.
A lot of people say they get their most inspiration in writing books from personal situations. Indirect or directly, do that motivate you to, like, your living testimony? Is that something that that people can find sometimes in your book about you by getting to know who Miss Sharon?
I know what you're saying. Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
No. I think experience drives it, but more or less, as a creative, my imagination and my ability to put things together as a story is what drives it. And, it can sound very real.
Yeah.
But it's not, because I'm a creative. and I have a huge imagination. So, and this started when I was a kid. When bad things happened to me, I imagine I was somewhere else. So that has been always like my, you know, one of my coping skills in life, my great imagination. Wow. So I think it's more or less of that.
And guess what? You know what? That's awesome that you say that, and it's not knocking that, you know, because I want people to know different elements about an author or a screenwriter, you know, because a lot of people feel like they come from personal experience, but like you said, and this good for a child that may look at it and be like, man, you know, or a parent be like, it's not crazy for my child to be in a, got this crazy
imagination, right?
Yes, it's not.
They can use that to create a lot of things, and just by your testimony can help somebody. So that's awesome just to hear
that. Oh, thank you. And I hope it does, because again, I get it all the time. Like with my series, people like, is this your life? It sounds realistic. And, you know, they were telling me to turn it into a movie before I decided to turn it into a movie. And I was like, no, this is not my life. Of course, I may have experienced a tad bit of things in there, but with my imagination, it could have been just, I walked through the door and something happened, but my imagination took it to the next level, you know? So it's like, no, I can't put that upon that. But to let your child or anybody to, you know, go into their imagination and be there, everyone is a dreamer, but only the real dreamers are going to take action and bring it to life.
Wow, that is so true.
And that's a wonderful gem right there that you actually dropped right there. Because by being a parent, you don't have a book of how to be a parent. You get what I'm saying? It comes with experience and stuff like that. So, you know, some people be like, man, why my kid dreaming so much? I need them to get on realistic type stuff, you know? And sitting here like, you don't know, you could be nursing that child to be an author. Another screenwriter. Something huge instead of trying
painter, any type of artistry. An actor, you don't know, because actors have great imaginations as well. They have to be different characters outside their self. So just, you know, you could be raising up a child that is full of art. And I don't think my parents knew that I was full of art back then either. Because of course you think about it, I'm over 40. So back then, you know, they wasn't into stuff. They, you know, you go on somewhere and sit down. You talking too much, you know, you making up stuff. It was different. But I know with my children growing up, I was more acceptable of seeing certain things in them that because I am a person of artistry as well.
That's something that, you know, we should open our kids to the mindset of art. You know, we always worry about STEM. You know, STEM is great. You know, science,
absolutely,
economics, not economics, but engineering and mathematics is always some great elements for us to be in, but we also need to know the creativity about art. You know, art can take our mind further. And it, be honest with you, art helps a lot with mental health. You get what I'm saying?
Exactly. And that's something that's lacking in our community. People, you know, that love the arts. That's meant to, you know, if you're not making movies or, you know, an actress or whatever, it's not as accepted. I love art. I love opera. I am just an art person in general. You know, so it's like you have to expand everything. Art is all around you. You know, everywhere you go, there's art, because this was someone's idea long before it became a reality. And that's art in itself. So yes, I agree. I told my children, like, I wanted them to graduate, and, you know, five of the eight did. Thank you, praise God. But I wasn't forcing them to go to college because right. it's not necessary for you to live a normal, normal, fulfilled life. Yeah, it's not that important for you. So it's so many millionaires and billionaires that never even made it out of 9th, 10th grade, but because their art, their drive and their motivation for what they love took them to the next level. So yeah.
But see, that's how it was raised back in the day, you know.
Yeah. Yeah.
Go to college, go to school.
Yes, you know, yes.
Get you a job with benefits. They didn't tell you go out there and be an entrepreneur. If school ain't working for you, go and be an entrepreneur, you know, right. and go and make your dreams true. No, right. I want to always create that stability, which is cool, but, you know, that's limit a lot of folks in their success, though. You
it
know?
Is, because for me, I always say, I live the American dream. I have 2 degrees. You know, I did the greatest jobs. I was wondering what was wrong with me that I did not want to work somebody's job. And I couldn't understand for the life of me what was going on. But then when I was writing and creating, I was at my highest form. And I was waking up every day happy. And then I realized what was happening here, you know? Yeah. But, of course, I tried the American dream. Right. And that is just not, that wasn't working for me at all. It's right. not working for me. Yeah. So, you know, I'm American without that dream. So, like, no.
Well, we do appreciate you for being on My Air.
Yes.
You know, and we will connect with you. And
yes.
We'll have more interviews to show you your talent. Okay. And things like that, but
thank you
for being on the air. We gratefully honored. It's an honor, you know.
Oh yeah,
it's an honor to be here, and thank you guys for having me. And keep pushing, Tracy. Yeah. God has His hands on you and you as well, because anybody who's around her is going to win. You know, it's God is amazing like that. So just keep doing what you're doing. I know you're going through a lot, but you keep pushing. Yes. And I know the feeling. I know the feeling. So yes. keep pushing until you get what you want. Yes. At the end of the day, the results is yours, not no one else's. So remember that. If yes. you don't get the results you want, then you keep going till you get there.
Yeah. So, I appreciate
yes, it. God is amazing and you can do it.
That's why God put, you know, he put us some amazing people together, you know.
Yes.
You know, I'm a risk taker. You know,
Me too.
I'm a risk taker at heart. Entrepreneur, you know, I've been an entrepreneur for many years. It kind of set me back going back to employment. But at the end of the day, I'm going to still bounce out that situation. Because
You are.
But what it said is for us to get further and stuff like that. So at the end, you know, it worth. You get what I'm saying?
Yes, yes.
So, and yes, God gonna bless her, and I always pushing her. You know,
yes, good.
She a gym.
Yes, yes.
Always my motivation every day.
Aww. Yes, just keep being who you are, Tracy.
Yeah,
okay. But thank you guys so much.
You
too. Thank you. Mwah.
Fred, I made me cry.
Girl, don't cry. Your lashes is too cute.
Look, now I gotta get ready for the next interview.
Yeah, them lashes too cute. Don't be crying over there.
Thank
again.
You, boo.
Love you too, girl.
Girl, this 2 months.
They look like it was yesterday, baby.
Girl, I pull them off every day, and I clean them off.
I do the same thing.
I redo them, and then I put another coat of
There you go. You ain't got to be spending all that money. Oh, don't let folks lie to you like that.
That's
okay. Beauty is cheap.
Yeah,
you know what you're doing.
That's right.
You know what you're doing. Yeah. Well, y'all have a great day, and have an awesome next interview.
And we definitely will. We definitely will connect.
Okay, yes. Make sure we do.
We got
yes.
you.
Yeah, because I want to have you on my show as a guest.
Well, honey, you let me know. Let me know when.
I will. Okay, I will.
Okay. All right.
Take care, baby. Talk to you
love
soon.
Love you.
Love you more.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
If you are enjoying all of our episodes on My Air with your lovely host, me, the one and the only Tracy Etheridge. Yeah, baby, that's me. But if you have not previously seen our episodes, please subscribe to our YouTube channel at My Air 2023. We also have a website, www.weareMyAir.com, where you can learn about My Air TV talk show as well as our My Air Foundation. We also, on our website, have an online merchandise My Air store that you can purchase some of our merchandise on.
Greetings.
My name is Tracy Newbill-Etheridge. If you are starting a business, have an existing business, or want to expand your business, contact Erica, your favorite agent, today.
Thank you, Tracy. My name is Erica Edmond, better known as Erica, your favorite agent. As Tracy stated, if you're starting a business, have an existing business, or expanding your business, please contact me today so we can make sure you have proper coverage today. I am licensed in multiple states. Please contact me at 404-596-8461 or 803-550-9928. Look forward to talking with you. Take care. Be blessed.